Sometimes you just need a little hope, a bite of something to start your day or smooth out the wrinkles of life. So grab a cup of coffee, take a breath, and let's put a little grace note on the song of our lives. As believers, we know that when tragedy hits, we can go straight to God with it. Do not pass go, do not collect $200. Just get on your knees and begin asking the Lord for His divine intervention. It's such a comfort to know that He cares about us and listens to our whispered and panicked pleas. I don't know how people go through the tragedies of life without the hope of God. Do non-believers turn to their friends, their therapists, to medication? I know they sometimes turn to alcohol and drugs, just like believers do. We just kind of reach out for whatever hope there is. What is it that could possibly bring the comfort that our Savior does? The problem is, we know everything else is fallible. So how can we heap our burdens on our family or our friends when we know they are already carrying their own? But God is always constant. He is always available. He is always ready to listen. What we need to remember is that He isn't just on board for the big potholes we tend to fall into from time to time. God is ready to hear every little concern we have. We can't talk to Him too much or get on His last nerve. Even the smallest concerns of our day-to-day existence are as important to Him as they are to us. We can never wear Him out. There's an old hymn that says, "I need Thee, oh I need Thee, every hour I need Thee. Bless me now, my Savior, I come to Thee." Scripture tells us that we don't have to worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. That scripture has carried me over many situations where I couldn't see any answer. When it all seemed hopeless, even before I knew there was a solution, my heart could be comforted just by knowing that God was on the job, that the peace that passes all understanding was available to me. If we can just grasp for a moment that He will always be there, no matter the size of our mountain, or the molehill for that matter, we would feel so much comfort. Only that knowledge can really get us through the everyday frustrations of life with grace. Now, I won't pretend that I'm able to do that all the time, but we're all a work in progress. There are times when God is with us when we don't even recognize it. I'm sure of that. After my husband died, I couldn't stand to be in the house where I had spent agonizing hours nursing him. The emptiness of the rooms just screamed at me, and I was beyond the point of tears, crying, screaming, pleading, denying. All of those options had been used up. So I would just get in my car and drive, sometimes all night long, anything to escape that dark, empty house that I had once called home. Though I didn't realize it at the time, I was not operating in my right mind. I know that I took terrible risks, driving aimlessly through dangerous neighborhoods and down unknown roads. Some mornings, I didn't even know how I found my way back. In particular, one day I was driving down the freeway when I was brought out of my grief-laced coma by the sound of a police siren behind me. I pulled over and a young cop walked up to the side of my car. I must have looked terrible, eyes swollen from crying, hair a mess, God knows what I was even wearing. He spoke softly but with direction. He said, "Ma'am, do you know how fast you were going?" I numbly shook my head. He said, "95 miles an hour." I promise you I had no idea, and I'm certainly not a good enough driver to handle those speeds. That was when I began to wake up, and I knew the jeopardy I was putting myself in. Today, I can say for certain that God was watching out for me even when I didn't know I needed His careful hand. How many times have we been rescued when we had no idea we were even drowning? Like children, we wander from near miss to near miss, not knowing how close to disaster we actually have been. It's hard to recognize a blessing or protection when you don't realize you need it. It occurs to me that we're probably never going to be grown-up Christians until we find ourselves permanently lodged with God in heaven. In the meantime, we're all on this journey of growing up together. We might not be babies in our years, but we're certainly always learning and growing in our relationship with the Lord. My goal is to remind myself to call on Him every hour. No matter the need, no matter the circumstance, God wants to be part of our every second. Only when we can praise Him through the chaos will we be able to truly praise Him in the blessings. Father, I'm so grateful that You hover over me like a helicopter dad during the times that I don't even recognize I need You. And thank You for being available for the many times that I do. When I call out after ignoring You for so long, You're still there. And when any of us call out in anger, You respond with love. When we call out from the depths of our pain, You hold our hearts with gentleness. Help us to grow, God, to learn to call on You for more than just our desires, but also in acknowledgement of all of those things You give us that we just seem to take for granted. Lord, we know You're there every moment, every hour, every day, and we give You all the honor and the glory for the many blessings in our lives. We love You, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Be blessed, my friend. God is on the throne. See you next time. If you're new to Grace Notes or Project Forgiveness, we hope you'll come back often. You can go to projectforgiveness.com to email a prayer request, send a comment, or a topic suggestion. Your thoughts matter to us. You can also go to Facebook, YouTube, or Instagram to like, share, comment, and subscribe. We care about you and your concerns, and we know that God has your very best in mind. Remember, you are not defined by your worst moment, because God's not finished with you yet. May the Lord richly bless you.